We're going now to the operatic quartet who've notched up a whopping 50 number ones across the world. And here performing tonight from West Side Story. Raise the roof, please. For Il Divo, let me hear you. Come on.
Just any night. Tonight there will be no morning star. Tonight, tonight, I'll see my love tonight. And for us, stars will stop where they are.
Nice to see you again.
How are you doing, Luke?
Hello. 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 Oh, gentlemen. Well, I tell you what, it's been a long time, hasn't it?
Absolutely.
Seen you for ages.
It's great to be here.
And you've been over on Broadway.
Absolutely, yeah.
I'm just going to read you, ladies, what they said in... Not since Sinatra packed the Paramount has there been such an explosion of oestrogen.
Was he drunk? Brilliant.
How fabulous. Did you have a good time on Broadway?
Oh, it was fantastic, yeah. We played six shows in the Marquee Theatre, right on Times Square.
Oh, wonderful.
And absolutely fabulous response to... We presented a repertoire from the new album.
Yeah,
musical
it's all Broadway... Well, it's not just Broadway songs, is it?
It's the best of Broadway songs.
It's all musicals. Yeah. Yeah. It's got my mother's favourite on it, Some Enchanted Evening.
Oh. You will see a stranger.
Yeah, and avoid the light of play.
That's my advice.
If a stranger looks at you across the room, get your coat and get out.
Yeah.
Because it'll be a nutter. You know it will. Definitely. How was it? I have to ask you, working with Miss Streisand, Barbara Streisand.
That was amazing. I mean,
I saw you at the O2 and she was on, because you were on with her.
Yeah. It was fantastic. I mean, was a unique experience. I mean, obviously, singing with such a huge icon, he was fantastic. And just only, I mean, watching her, how she interacted with the audience, that was amazing.
And she's not scary, is she?
No, not at all.
It's lovely.
And now, because I had to interview her, I was terrified. See?
Really?
Yeah, because I've been a huge fan, you know, since I was an embryo, and I thought, oh my God, Barbara Streisand, and she's there, and of course I took my dog Buster, and she had her little dog with her.
Oh yeah.
So as I'm interviewing the great lady, I look down and I see Buster, and he's. And I thought, Barbara, please don't look down. Please don't look down. And
she went, where did you learn that from?
Not from me. He's fly, isn't he, this one? But he was in like Flynn, honestly, on Barbara's dog, and I thought, oh, please, let's hope you've had your dog spayed, Barbara, otherwise I'm going to have a litter of puppies here on me. But she's a gracious lady, isn't she?
Yeah, absolutely.
She really
Apparently,
is.
Apparently, she was quite nervous to meet us.
I bet she would be.
Because we were in a big rehearsal studio in Culver City in LA, and she was standing down in the dark, and we were up on stage. We had already been rehearsing, and she was like, really, like.
Bit intimidated?
Yeah, well, I don't know why, but she was.
That's great, though, isn't it?
Completely friendly.
Don't you think? Yeah. So, what's happening for you now? What are you going to do? Are you touring? Is it worldwide?
Well, the album is out today, so we're very excited. It's a big debt for us. A musical affair. We've put a lot of work into it because after 10 years we wanted to change a little bit things around, and I think, you know, it's working really well and we have a lot of good time. We just were in Broadway in New York performing, you know, the musical affair tour. And that was, like, sensational to be there for 6 nights only. We had a wonderful time. We had amazing performances. We had Heather Headley.
You had wonderful reviews.
Exactly.
I mean, like, astounding ones. Fabulous.
Yeah, yeah.
Look, you know how snotty they are over there, them critics. They wouldn't laugh if they saw the chair walk. Well, they wouldn't. No, it's all going to be painted and highbrow or they don't want to know. And, I mean, so to get the New York critics on your side, yeah, well, it's a testament to you, isn't it, to your performance? Because they went absolute. I was reading them online. They went mad. Mm. It was brilliant.
Yeah, yeah, and we were a bit nervous about that, obviously, because it's not a real Broadway show, what we do. It's still Il Divo singing Broadway repertoire, you know? But, yeah, it got accepted from that crowd, so we're very happy about that.
So are you going to tour now? Are you going to tour around the world?
Yep, we're going to take it on tour next year.
Where are you going to?
Everywhere that'll have us. And we'll be coming... It's true. That sounds a bit cheeky, but,
Be very careful, because that woman over there, she lives in Bridgend. You're going to end up in her back kitchen if you're not careful. Tied up.
We'll be near you, then.
Coming back here to the UK in October.
Yeah.
And, very exciting.
And you never stop, do you? Never.
It's not like really,
busy. No. I remember, it was at Venice Airport I bumped into you. Who was it I saw? Oh. It was one of you, remember?
Me?
Was it you?
Yeah, I didn't have the suit on.
Where was it? And I looked down and I thought, I know him from somewhere. So I went and sort of stood next to you and I thought, he's probably thinking I'm trying to pick him up here.
I saw the dog, that's what...
That's what it was.
Did he look different in flip-flops and shorts?
Yeah, well, actually...
Yeah, that's on a Spanish donkey under his arm.
That's the greatest thing about being an Il Divo. As soon as you don't have a suit on, people wouldn't... Really, they would be like, I don't know, but they don't know. Yeah.
Oh, I think
that's
they
a high-class problem, isn't it? That's
would you recognise these guys, ladies?
Yeah, I do.
Would you recognise them in the dark? Yeah! Oh, using your hands? You're all over your faces. Listen, fellas, thank you so much for coming in.
Thank you.
It's a beautiful album. Good luck with it. And good luck with everything you're doing.
Thank you.